Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the first match of the VWF Elimination Chamber. We have quite a lineup for you tonight. Introducing first, Lotus. First match here will be a Falls Count Anywhere match between two of our newest competitors here in the Virtual Wrestling Federation. First match for both of these, and we shall see who shall provide the upper hand here. Ladies and gentlemen, and introducing his competitor from Valhalla, it is Wendigo. Not much known about either of these two competitors here. As I said, this is their first match here in the Virtual Wrestling Federation, kind of giving them an opportunity to showcase themselves against each other, and we shall see how everything goes for this evening. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we are off. For those that do not know, of course, a pinfalls count anywhere match means that the pinfall does not have to happen in the ring. It can happen ringside, backstage, ramp, anywhere these two can try to pin one another, the pinfalls will count. Wendigo taking the early advantage here. And Lotus with a counter. Lotus going to the outside. What is Lotus going for? Reaching under the ring. This can never be a good sign. Oh, and we have a chair. Oh, but Wendigo takes the chair and throws it away. Wendigo obviously not too happy about that there. Looking to maybe exact a little bit of revenge. Back outside the ring. Lotus with a kick to the knee for a counter there. Obviously knowing which way this match wants to go. Not for sure where Lotus was going there. Maybe just trying to get away from Wendigo. Afraid maybe of a little bit of payback. Grabbing it, and a drop kick on the steel ramp there. It's got to be a little bit painful for Wendigo. We can see Lotus going back under the ring again, seeing what he can find. And it looks like, oh, we have a baseball bat in play now. Oh, that one's got to hurt. I've got to say, I can't think Wendigo's going to be able to take much more of that. Lotus going for the pinfall. Only getting a two count. It looks like it may take a little bit more than that to put Wendigo away. Into the ring apron. What does Wendigo have in mind here? Camera angle could be a little bit better. View is obstructed by a little bit of the scenery here. I apologize for that, ladies and gentlemen. Perhaps maybe fire the cameraman next time. Wendigo going for a pinfall. One, two, and no, kick out before three. Lotus is still going at it in this match. See, Wendigo, I believe, still trying to exact some punishment here on Lotus. Oh, and the head into the ramp. That one's not going to feel good in the morning. One thing we do know, unfortunately, not able to be here in this match, we do know Wendigo does have a manager referred to as Loki. Be interesting to see how the manager plays out in future matches here. Actually part of a recent influx of management that we've had here in the Virtual Wrestling Federation. And Lotus going back for the baseball bats. Oh, Wendigo saying not happening today. Oh, and Wendigo with a bat to the face on Lotus. And now going to town. You got to feel this is payback for what Lotus did before. What have we got going on here? Oh, a powerbomb. On that padding outside the ring. Cannot feel that great. I believe Lotus may now be... Yes, Lotus is bleeding. And still another kick out. Lotus is still hanging in there. Bat right there by Lotus. And gotta wonder, Lotus did not go for the bat. Is he even still aware of where he is at? Wendigo putting a pounding on Lotus right now. We'll ask Lotus here not to bleed all over the nice, fresh ring mat that we have. As you all can tell, of course, tonight's event brought to you by X1 Bros, your positive gaming experience. Wendigo with a neck breaker. Looks like Wendigo may be wearing out here. You got to think those chair shots earlier have taken effect on Wendigo. You can tell he is feeling it, barely getting the pin cover there. And still another kick out. Maybe had he gotten a little bit of leverage, a little bit of a better pin attempt. I mean, that looked pretty half-hearted, whether it's just exhaustion at this point or he is damaged. Oh, it looks like he's signaling for something special. Believe he calls this move the whiteout. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. You have your winner. After hitting the whiteout, Wendigo gets the 1-2-3. So we have two new competitors in the VWF. One of them is now 1-0. Quite an impressive performance by both competitors there. Look forward to seeing what both of them have in store for them in the future. And now we shall prepare for our next match, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Denver, Colorado, being accompanied to the ring by Sarah Knight, Jack Blaze O'Reilly. And his opponent, from Cincinnati, Ohio, Stormy Mao. Now, what some don't know about this match here, set up by our commissioner at the time, Stacy Hancock. Jack Blaze O'Reilly's first match here in the Virtual Wrestling Federation. Stacy decided to put Blaze in a match, give him a chance to earn a contract here. Unfortunately, at that same time, Stacy had decided she was not impressed with the performances by Stormy so far. Kind of made it sound if Stormy doesn't win, he may not have a job here anymore. We will just kind of have to see what happens. And they are off. A lot on the line for both of these competitors here. It'll be interesting to see how the match plays out. Do know we had an incident after the most recent Thursday night brawl where in the backstage area, Stormy proceeded to take out Blaze. See if Blaze is perhaps wanting a little bit of vindication for that at backstage attack. Oh, nice little flying forearm there. Blaze definitely going on the offensive here. Decent little jumping arm breaker from Blaze. Quick attacks. Knee to the face. Oh, going for a camel clutch. And let it go. Looks like he was just trying to tire his opponent out, maybe, not actually getting to submit. DDT is showing all offense from Blaze here so far. Oh, but a counter by Stormy. Stormy getting back into it. Oh, no. Fireman's carry by Blaze to counter again. And knocking him to the outside of the ring. Definitely want to make sure we don't hit Sarah there. Blaze throwing Stormy into the barricade. Another series of quick punches by Blaze here. Oh, Stormy countering with his own punch. And a neck breaker. And getting back into the ring. Decent little midsection dropkick there by Stormy. Looks like Stormy is definitely ready to go with this. Oh, but a nice counter by Blaze. Blaze dragging Stormy into the middle of the ring and going for the pinfall. One, two. I know we have a kick out. Kick to the back is never enjoyable. Oh, Stormy with another nice counter. What does Stormy have in mind here? Swinging neck breaker. Decent move. Looks like going after the knees of Blaze here. Oh, Blaze countering. All I can say to that one is ouch. Irish whip. Into a side slam. Oh, Blaze looks like he's going to the top rope. We'll be seeing his signature move. No, just a flying cross body, but the ref is down. No way to make the pin here. What do we have coming now? 450 splash. Signature move there. Ref is finally back up, but only a two count. Blaze, gotta maybe give it a little bit more. Stormy looking, still fighting, still trying to stay in this match here. Trying to work on the head and neck there of Stormy. And I gotta say, Stormy, if I were you, I would not get up right now. I think we may be seeing this finishing move. And diamond cutter. This may be all over, ladies and gentlemen. He hits the finishing move. There may be no returning. And that is it, ladies and gentlemen. Jack Blaze O'Reilly has won his inaugural match here in the Virtual Wrestling Federation. Sarah praising Jack. Jack looking very happy with the win. Do believe this means that Mr. Blaze O'Reilly shall be offered a contract here with the Virtual Wrestling Federation, if I can get my words out correctly. Ladies and gentlemen, let's see what our next match has in store for us.
Three men, one cell, one goal, the coveted BWF TV title. Each seeks it for their own reason. A veteran's pride. Kid, Nikki. A hero's goal. Craig, the Angel, Casey. A villain's wrath. D.B. Black in a triple threat match. VWF and X1 Bros presents VWF's Hell in a Cell at the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view this Thursday, June 9th, 2016.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following match is scheduled for one fall. It is a triple threat Hell in a Cell match, and it is for the VWF television title. Introducing first, from the Order of Holy Light, Kid Nikki. Hell in the Cell hanging above the ring, waiting for the competitors to enter and be lowered down. And introducing second, our next challenger. From Kansas City, Missouri, Craig Angel Casey. And finally, introducing your current VWF television champion, also from Kansas City, Missouri, D.B. Black. there is the television championship that is on the line tonight in this triple threat match. You see the cage being lowered in the background. All three competitors ready to go here. And they are off. For those of you that have not been following us for long, this rivalry between these three has actually been going on for quite a while. Of course, Kid Nicky, one of the VWF originals back since the early days of the Virtual Wrestling Federation in the late 90s, early 2000s, before it went on hiatus. Kind of considered an old-timer by a couple of these new members here with DB Black and Craig Angel Casey. Kid Nicky feels, of course, this is his ring. Has really kind of been calling out Angel for being a rookie. Kind of his favorite phrase to use. And, of course, DB Black just being the man that just wants to inflict pain on anyone and everyone that he can. Of course, our Craig Casey here was our previous television champion. Lost the title to Mr. Black at the last pay-per-view. Kid Nicky kind of felt he was next in line for a shot at the title. Of course, Craig Casey wanted his rematch. It was set up, and it was actually in a match just on our last Thursday Night Brawl. Kid Nicky secured his place in this match by beating Craig Casey. Had he lost, he would have been out of this triple threat match here, but he did win, so instead of just a one-on-one match, we now have a triple threat. You can see Kid Nicky there trying to go for the submission. Craig Casey interfering. Make sure it is not going to be allowed. DB Black with a counter on Kid Nicky. And Nicky with a counter of his own. Oh, but Craig Casey, Angel, making sure he is in here. DB Black, also a member of our corporate stable here, kind of a personal henchman for our commissioner, Stacy Hancock. Other members, of course, being Bapo and Yakuza and Chainsaw. For those that did not see, after our most recent Thursday Night Brawl, we did actually have an attack, two separate attacks in the backstage area on DB, or not on DB Black, I'm sorry, on Yakuza and on Bapo the Clown. You know, some people were wondering, was DB Black worried for himself? He did make a statement, of course, saying he was not concerned about this. Black has always kind of been a man, even though he's been part of the corporation, to stand on his own. Oh, seeing some teamwork here between Kid Nicky and Angel. Yeah, I don't know, that's not going to last. And there it goes right there. Had to know if Angel went for the win. Kid Nicky was not going to let that happen and make sure he could put a stop to it. Headbutt by DB Black. Black lifting him up on the ropes. Oh, and that's gotta hurt your gut. Hopefully he didn't just eat lunch. Kid Nicky kind of standing back watching, maybe taking his time, biting for the right moment. Craig Casey making sure that he's going to take care of both of them, but Kid Nicky with the counter. Kid Nicky dropping him with the DDT. Surprised we have not seen the chair come into play more often than it has already. Not sure that Kid Nicky will use it. He does pride himself of being honorable. Nice little flip counter there. Casey taking him up to the top ropes. What are we going here for? Are we going to see a top rope superplex? Oh! On his face. Probably going for the pin, but DB Black is not going to allow that to happen. DB Black going for a pin for himself. One, two. Ooh, Kid Nicky getting in there and breaking it up just in the nick of time. Gotta wonder, DB Black has said that he doesn't matter, he will come out of this pay-per-view with at least one title. Of course, he is also a member of our Elimination Chamber main event later this evening. Kind of got to feel the odds are not really in Mr. Black's favor at this time. It is the first person to achieve pinfall or submission. He's got two opponents in there, and of course, he doesn't even have to be pinned to lose his title. One, and Angel making the save. Looks like they are taking their turns, having their way with DB Black. Oh, but wait a minute. I see Angel going for the Pride Lock there. Kid Nikki going in and making sure that DB Black does not submit, making sure he does not lose his chance at the title. Not for sure why Kid Nikki did not interfere there. Maybe he knew that the pinfall was not going to go through. Maybe he knew Black was not done yet. Ooh, a vicious chop, and Kid Nikki goes down. You got to realize in a match like this, you have to find a way to take care of both of your opponents, because otherwise the other one is just going to stop whatever you're going for. Angel looking like he's preparing for something. Oh, it looks like they both go for it at the same time. And now Angel, oh, he is getting the Deathly Hallows on Kid Nikki. Now he's going after Black into the corners. Setting him up on the top rope. Are we going to see another? Oh no, a counter by DB Black. And a counter by Angel. Kid Nikki with the claw! Stopped by DB Black. And you have to wonder, like I've said before, how long until we actually have a chance to get a pinfall or submission here. With 3 men, it just makes it that much harder. And you can see these 3 men giving it their all. There is the Shanghai Surprise by Kid Nikki. And a kick out at 2.5 by DB Black. Now seeing both Angel and Kid Nikki get their finishing moves off. Gotta wonder, is DB Black far behind, or is just DB Black going to be on the receiving end of the punishment tonight? Kid Nikki missing with the rebound off the Irish whip there. Kid Nikki posing for the crowd, maybe trying to get the crowd behind him a little bit. Again with the Irish whip, but oh, into a Hurricane Rana. 2 men are down. What is Kid Nikki going for now? And a boom drop by Kid Nikki. And we have a pin attempt. 1, 2, and only a 2 count. You can tell this match has taken its toll on DP Black. He is sitting there trying to catch his breath at this point in time. He is finally back up now. It looks like he is going to try to make his presence known. Kid Nikki back in it, trying to remove him from the match again. And a bulldog out from the corner. Angel going after Nikki. What are we going for here? Oh, a knee to the back. Honestly tell you at this point, ladies and gentlemen, I have no clue who is going to win this match. This has been back and forth. Kid Nikki with the craw again. DB Black back on his feet and stopping the submission attempt. Craig Casey fighting to get to his feet at this point in time. Oh, DB Black not allowing Angel to get the move off on Kid Nikki. Going to the center of the ring, and we are going for the Pride Lock again. And again, DB Black saying, no, not on my watch. This is my belt. I will not let you get the submission. Oh, wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. I believe we may be seeing the reverse Death Valley driver here by DB Black. Now all three men have gotten their finishers off. Can he capitalize? Trying to remove Kid Nikki from the equation here, whipping him into the corner. Sorry there that the lights dimmed there for a second. I believe actually in that moment we missed Angel being busted open. DB Black sidestepping Kid Nikki. Taking him down. Oh, going to a knee himself. Going for a pinfall. Can Angel make it up in time? One, two. Oh, but Kid Nikki actually kicks out at two. Match continues. DB Black may be a little frustrated there. He didn't get the count. Kick to the back on Kid Nikki. And now both men taking their turns, proceeding to pound Kid Nikki into the mat. Believe Angel has something specific in mind here. Looks like he has maybe reconsidered, letting DB Black inflict a little bit more punishment on him. Kid Nikki with the counter there. Oh, and DB Black and Angel tag teaming Kid Nikki here. Irish whip into the corner. DB Black trying to capitalize on it here. Setting Nikki up on the top rope. Oh, Angel going for Russian leg sweep there. Oh, Kid Nikki flying off the top rope, but it looks like he maybe got more of the mat than of either competitor there. Angel wiping away a little bit of blood. Kid Nikki with another counter. Oh! Pop-up powerbomb, ladies and gentlemen! You know, when you see the pop-up powerbomb, that reverse Death Valley driver is not far behind. Clothesline in the corner by DB Black. Kid Nikki slowly getting to his feet, and he is back up. Angel with a reversal. Whip into the corner. But Kid Nikki stopping him with the DDT. Nikki looks like he may be waiting for the Shanghai surprise, but it looks like we will have the reverse Death Valley driver by DB Black first. Kid Nikki trying to capitalize with the pin. You gotta figure DB Black is not gonna be happy with that. DB Black whipping him into the corner in retaliation. Angel standing back to his feet. Oh, Kid Nikki sidestepped out of the way, and Black got nothing but turnbuckle. And now we have the Deathly Hallows again by Angel on Kid Nikki. Going for the pin, DB Black saying no, not happening. For another pinfall attempt here. Kid Nikki breaking this one up. One. Sure believed we might have seen it with the mask. It's hard to tell. Looks like DB Black may have been busted open a little bit here. Men going to a knee after a move. You can tell these men are feeling the effects of this match. You've got to wonder how any of the three of these are going to be able to compete in the Elimination Chamber later on this evening. Kid Nicky picking back up. Thought he might go for the pinfall there. Ah, but he is going for the craw. Angel standing up, finally realizing what's going on and making the save there. Dropping him down, going to a knee. Can he make the pinfall attempt in time? Looking, trying to decide which man to go after. Both men slowly getting to their feet. Angel knocking Kid Nicky back down, though. But TV Black taking advantage while he's down. Going for the pinfall. Angel saying no. Dragging him to the center of the ring. What does he have in store here? Oh, we're seeing a gator roll. Now going for a new submission here. Kid Nicky just kind of standing back, wondering what's going on there. Maybe trying to regain his senses after a little bit of the beating he has taken in this match. Or maybe just plotting his move. Looks like he was maybe getting ready to hit the Shanghai Surprise there. Pride lock in effect again. Kid Nicky making sure to break that up. Angel going for the pinfall. One. Kid Nicky again breaking the attempt up. Kid Nicky just waiting for Angel to stand up here. Shanghai Surprise in effect. DB Black is up though. And he stops the pinfall. Headbutt by DB Black. Pop-up powerbomb. But Angel making sure to make the save. Waiting to see here what move is going to be pulled off next. And when will we hit a point that either of these men are not able to stand up? I said either, I meant any of the three of these men, sorry there. DB Black maybe kind of standing back, biding his time, catching his breath. Looks like Angel is putting Kid Nicky back up on the top rope. Oh, but Kid Nicky counters. DB Black taking down Angel. Waiting for him to get up. With a splash, and that has got to be a great pinfall attempt. But did he really think that was going to be successful with Black standing right there? DB Black has now picked up the chair that's been sitting here for about 20 minutes. Oh, no, he dropped it back down again. Have the Deathly Hallows in effect. DB Black just not sure what he wants to do with this chair. It is stopping the pinfall attempt once again, though. Oh, I think Black was getting ready to go for the reverse Death Valley Driver, and Angel got in the way. Oh, Black obviously not happy with that. Oh, Angel with a counter. Kid Nicky is on the ground. Black with a counter now. Ooh, and a super kick out of nowhere. Looks like he is not done with Angel. Setting him up just to kick him in the back. pop-up powerbomb, ladies and gentlemen. Again, Kidnicki up. Is he aware? Yes, he is. Both men going after DB Black here. Nicky saying, no, he's mine. DB Black countering. Irish whip into the corner. Kidnicki moving very slow at this point. Yeah, I figure after 20 minutes, these men have got to be wearing down. Kidnicki going to the outside. Jumping back in. Maybe he had something in mind there, but of course Angel got in his way. Both men down. Kidnicki picking Angel back up. Angel counters. Oh, DB Black with a punch to the back. Counter by Angel, making sure Black is not getting the move off. Keep dragging him into the center of the room. Got to figure what he's going for there. Angel just making sure whatever it is not going to happen. Angel going for a pinfall attempt, of course, quickly broken up by Kidnicki. Kidnicki going for a pinfall. DB Black breaking it up this time. These men are definitely giving it their all here this evening. You've got to wonder whoever comes out of this as champion is going to be well earned at this point in time. Really got to be honest and say I'm surprised that the cell has not come into play more often. These men tending to keep it in the ring for the whole match with everything else that they have available to them. Wait a minute, are we going to see Kidnicki go for a pinfall attempt again here? DB Black slowly getting to his feet. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a winner! After barely making it into this match, your winner and new VWF Television Champion, Kidnicki! Congratulate Kidnicki on his win. Gotta say, you better rest up though. You've got another match later tonight. And that one is going to be a doozy. Are you going to be able to survive the evening? And unfortunately, with the sellout here, Jess is not able to come out and celebrate with Kidnicki. But I'm sure we will hear from both of them very soon regarding a hard-fought victory there by Kidnicki. Ladies and gentlemen, up next, our 20-man battle royal to determine who will be our new VWF Tag Team Champions. Ladies and gentlemen, the following match is a 20-man Royal Rumble match. The winner of this match will be able to choose a partner of his choosing. And those two will be your VWF Tag Team Champions. Not sure what Lillian is in the ring saying, but we will let her continue. And here comes our first entry into the Royal Rumble match. Shadow, part of the IWO as a tag team, along with Wang Tang. It's been quiet here lately here in the VWF. I've not actually heard much from Shadow lately. Good to see him kind of making a return to the ring here. Maybe the start of some wonderful things to come here. obviously has his eyes on the tag team title of being part of a previous tag team. Random entries here into the match, so we do not know who will actually be in here. Can tell you we've had several different tag teams in the past that have been active competitors in the VWF. As I mentioned before, we had the IWO that included Shadow and former VWF heavyweight champion Wang Tang. Another one would be Raging Storm that we have seen recently in action, consisting of Chode and Thunder. Area 51, of course, just in action this last Thursday Night Brawl in their unfortunate loss against Helldrifter and DB Black. Area 51 is Tsuji Sato and Scott Doc Carrity. We have our second competitor starting to make their entrance now. In the second match this evening, we have another new VWF competitor. This is Lotus. Pay no attention to the notifications. Had forgotten to turn those off here. Lotus, of course, faced Wendigo earlier in the evening in our opening match for the night. Good to see Lotus has recovered from that match and is now ready to enter the tag team scene. As you know, the entry rules for a Royal Rumble, two men start off in the ring. Every 2 minutes, another competitor comes down. A little modification here. We were told by the building owners, unfortunately, that the ring can only accompany up to or accommodate up to six wrestlers at once. Once we have six wrestlers in the ring, that timer will stop. So we cannot have any more than that. Once someone is eliminated by being thrown over the top rope at that point, then we can start and another competitor will enter in the ring until all 20 men have entered the ring. Of course, the last man standing will be the winner of the match. And as stated before, that person will pick a partner of his choosing and they will automatically receive the tag team championship. And Shadow being thrown over the top rope already, but coming back in. Timer go off. I believe we have another competitor coming down to the ring. Looks to be Chuck Sato. Chuck and Shadow teaming up to try to eliminate Lotus right away. Lotus fighting back though. As stated before, the only way to be eliminated from this match is to be thrown over the top rope and have both of your feet touch the floor. Chuck Sato, actually originally part of a tag team, Chaos Squared, him and Helldrifter. That was in the early days of the Virtual Wrestling Federation. That team has not competed together lately. And we have our timer off again. We now have another competitor coming down to the ring. And it is DB Black. DB Black, part of our VWF television title match. The man has got to be feeling the pain from that still, but is right in it. It'd be interesting to see, being part of the corporation, who DB Black would choose as his tag team partner. Obviously, he would have several different options. Would be Boppo, Chainsaw, Yakuza. Chuck was out on the apron, but he did climb back in. Chuck throwing Shadow out. Going for elimination. Can he knock Shadow off of the apron? And our buzzer goes off. We have another competitor coming in. Shadow climbing back into the ring, staying safe. And as I mentioned earlier, there is one half of Area 51 with Scott Carrity, sometimes known as Doc. Five men in the ring currently. Does get a little hectic and chaotic. I will try my best to keep up with all of the action for you, ladies and gentlemen. I make no qualms that I may not miss something, though. Looks like we have Shadow and DB Black both on the outside. Waiting to see if either is eliminated. No, Shadow looks to be safe and climbing back in. Buzzer is off. We have another competitor coming. And our first elimination, DB Black, has been eliminated from the tag team match. Looks like we saw on the ramp that Satan will be our next competitor coming to the ring. Actually used to be part of the tag team Pure Evil alongside Chaos Warrior. Scott going to work on Lotus. It looks like Shadow and Chuck. Oh, now Satan and Chuck. Shadow joining in, trying to eliminate Chuck from the ring here. Oh, Lotus has Doc up against the ropes. Chuck managed to escape. Satan seem to go at it. Lotus and Doc kind of working on Shadow here. Doc is picking Shadow up. Going to throw him out. No. No, it was countered by Shadow. Satan is on the apron now. Chuck trying to eliminate him. Who is our next competitor to enter the ring? Chuck has eliminated Satan. We have two competitors down. 17 more eliminations to go. Still waiting to see who our next competitor is. They have not come down the ramp. Oh, it would be Rugby would be our next competitor. I've actually not seen anything out of Rugby for a while here in the Virtual Wrestling Federation. Looks like he is ready to take a go and become a tag team champion, though. Trying to take Chuck down. Rugby with a quick throw to the apron on Shadow. Shadow coming back up over the top rope. Doc with a big boot on Rugby there. Oh, Doc turning his attention to Shadow at this point. Rugby now taking his attention on Shadow. Lotus and Chuck still going at it. Doc throwing Rugby out. From the music, it sounds like Craig the Angel Casey is our next competitor, and there he is in the ring. We have Shadow and Chuck both on the outside. Rugby has eliminated Shadow. There is one more competitor down. Lotus is trying to push Chuck out of the ring, trying to get another elimination here. Angel throwing Rugby over the top rope, getting onto the apron. Can he push him out? Chuck now trying to throw Lotus out. Looks like Rugby is safe and back in. Doc now trying to push Lotus down. And we have an elimination. Apologize, ladies and gentlemen. I should probably keep track of how many eliminations we have. I do not have those numbers at the moment. I shall try to keep you updated on those and see what we can do. Maybe we will, in post-production here, maybe get a counter added at the bottom. We shall see on that. Rugby throwing Doc over the top rope. A little back and forth here between Doc and Rugby. Angel trying to take on Chuck here in the middle of the ring. And Doc with a headbutt there to the midsection, and he is back in. I don't know, it's a headbutt, maybe a shoulder block there. And who do we have in next? The buzzer has gone off. We have another competitor coming down to the ring. It is Kid Nicky. Chuck has seen better days, laying in the ring trying to recover. Is now finally slowly getting up to his feet here. Angel and Doc going at it, and we have Doc kind of on the ring post. Oh, but Chuck trying to take advantage of the Irish whip there. Kid Nicky into the corner and being picked up by Rugby. And the buzzer has gone off. We have another entry into the match. It is Jack Blaze O'Reilly, another one of our new entries into the Virtual Wrestling Federation here. Someone being as new as this, you kind of got to wonder who Blaze would choose as his tag team partner. Doc with another elimination. Chuck Sato has been eliminated from the match now. During that, it looks like Kid Nicky maybe got thrown over the top, but he did climb back in. Oh, Doc has been thrown over the top rope. Laying on the apron, looks like he's climbing back in. Angel under the bottom rope did get thrown over the top. If he is knocked to the floor, it is over. Rugby trying to push Nikki, shoulder blocked by Kid Nikki, and back in the ring. Angel now throwing Blaze against the ropes. Looks like he is just going to try to push him over directly. Oh, but Blaze with a counter with a punch. Does not look to be happy about trying to be eliminated by Angel there. Flying. Oh! I think Blaze was going for an elbow drop onto Angel, but he caught Rugby in the face with that flying elbow. Kid Nicky going after. Oh, I don't know what Kid Nicky was doing there. He got scared by something. I thought at first he was going to go for a springboard move against Doc there, but he kind of hesitated and stopped. I'm not for sure if maybe he saw Michael Cole and that sight scared him or exactly what happened there. Doc looking to see who the next entry is, and it, of course, is Hell Drifter. As I kind of stated earlier, you know, most recent tag team matchup on Thursday Night Brawl was, of course, Hell Drifter and DB Black teaming up against Tsuji and Doc of Area 51. Tsuji and Doc, unfortunately, on the losing end of that match in their eyes. I'm sure Hell Drifter and DB Black were very happy with the win there. Hell Drifter going straight back against Doc, though. Doc is back in the ring. Still have Angel and Blaze going at it. See, Kid Nicky is currently working on Rugby. Doc now. Oh, Blaze. Oh, we have 3 men attempting to throw Hell Drifter out, and Hell Drifter has been eliminated. A team effort from Blaze, Angel, and Doc. Doc trying to return the favor to Blaze by throwing him out of the ring. Angel standing, I think, kind of watching, catching his breath, watching to see where his best opportunity to strike is. Obviously, it is going against Kid Nicky. And Doc has another elimination. Blaze has been eliminated from the match. Rugby with a back body drop on Doc. And a kick to the back now. Doc returning in kind with a scoop power slam. Doc seems to be a little wore out. I'd say multiple eliminations can do that for you. Of course, a big man, but it still takes a lot to lift people over the rope. Angel going to the outside looks a little dangerous. Kid Nicky trying to take advantage of that and eliminate him at this point in time. And Kid Nicky has eliminated Craig the Angel Casey. Angel not happy about that. Of course, you know, from our match earlier, a little bit of a rivalry there between Angel and Kid Nicky. Kid Nicky considering calling Angel a rookie constantly, messing in his ring. Of course, we have another entry coming down to the ring. Would be another member of the Corporation Yakuza. And Kid Nicky has been eliminated by Doc and Rugby. Looks like we will only have, so far, one title for Kid Nicky this evening. Of course, if you did not watch the television title match earlier, Kid Nicky, of course, is our new television champion. It looks like we have our 2 big men going at it between Yakuza and Doc there. Rugby joining in with a shot to the back. Biting his time. And buzzer went off. We have another entrant competitor coming down to join the match. Looks to be Whirling Dervish. Dervish, one of our silent competitors here, never really says much, has been around not since the inception of the Virtual Wrestling Federation. but is one of the old blood per se. Looks like Rugby is trying to lift Yakuza up, and Yakuza is having nothing of it. So instead, he'll just throw him over the ropes. And both big men are on the outside. Yakuza with a shoulder block. Doc with a shoulder block. Oh, a sit-down powerbomb by Yakuza. Dervish throwing Doc out of the ring again. And Doc has now been eliminated. Whirling Dervish has eliminated Doc. Trying to judge by the music who our next competitor coming down is. It is our new entrant, Wendigo. Wendigo, of course, having his first match in the VWF here tonight in our opening match, taking on earlier entry in the Royal Rumble, Lotus. And Rugby has now been eliminated by Yakuza. We are down to three men in the ring, waiting for the buzzer to go off for our next entrant to come down. Oh, a vicious kick by Dervish on both men. Counter by Wendigo. Oh, but being picked up by Yakuza. And a counter into a DDT by Wendigo. And Wang Tang is our newest entrance. Could tell by the music there. Of course, former VWF World Heavyweight Champion. As I mentioned, tag team partner of one of the original entrants in the Rumble here, Shadow, as part of the IWO. Dervish trying to eliminate Wendigo. Wendigo countering. Looks like Wang Tang has now thrown Yakuza to the outside and is trying to eliminate him. And Wang Tang has eliminated Yakuza. Now Wang Tang now going after Wendigo. And the timer going off again. Our next competitor coming down to the ring is Toril the Barbarian. Toril actually part of a tag team, Barbarian Horde. Him and fellow competitor Bear had their ups and downs. They were a tag team in a feud for a while, actually against Wang Tang and Shadow. Kind of saw maybe the disintegration of the tag team at that point, though. I think Toril got a little frustrated. And after one of their matches, proceeded to beat Bear backstage. Bear has come back recently. They have had matches together. Been a little surprised, so not surprised to see Toril and Wang Tang go after each other after that tag team rivalry they had there. Believe with our newest music, Thunder is our next competitor into the Royal Rumble. Of course, as I mentioned before, part of the tag team Raging Storm with him and Chode. Thunder wasting no time going after Wendigo here. Throwing him out, but not going after him. Now proceeding to try to throw Dervish outside of the ring, too. Looks like Wendigo and Thunder teaming up to take out Dervish. Wang Tang has Toril on the outside of the ropes. Dervish fighting his way back. Toril fighting his way back, too. Both men back in the ring. Wang Tang countering the move there by Toril. Buzzer goes off. We have another entrant coming down. Tsuji Sato, ladies and gentlemen, your VWF World Heavyweight Champion is now in the match. As we know from recent promos from Tsuji, this is really the match he was looking forward to the most. Tag team is where he got his start. It says he'd be nothing without Doc and Area 51. Unfortunately, looks like Wendigo is looking, trying to make short work of Tsuji here. Toril trying to eliminate Whirling Dervish there. Tsuji fought back. Dervish fought back. As I stated before, of course, we can only have six men in the ring at once, so until we have an elimination, we cannot have another entry into the match. Dervish, of course, trying to make sure that happens by throwing Toril out. Wendigo still having his sights set on the heavyweight championship here. Or not on the heavyweight championship, but I mean the heavyweight champion. Of course, obviously, the best way to go about getting anything done is go after the big dog. Tsuji obviously with a target on his back, being the heavyweight champion. Thunder working on eliminating Wang Tang here. Tsuji finally getting a little bit of a comeback here against Wendigo. Oh, but Wendigo saying no and countered that with a clothesline. Wang Tang throwing Toril against the ropes, trying to push him out. And Thunder fighting back. Thunder now going against Wang Tang to see what he can get done. Whip into the corner. Toro with a big boot on Dervish. Tsuji up on the top turnbuckle. And Dervish has Toril thrown to the outside. Toril is a shoulder block and back in and safe. Trying to perhaps maybe push Wang or push Whirling Dervish over the top rope. Dervish not having any of it. A push down by Toril though. Oh, Wendigo raising his arm, thinking maybe he's got this against Tsuji here. He has him thrown over the top rope. Trying to push Tsuji out of the ring here. Tsuji is safe with the shoulder block and climbing back in the ring at the moment. And Wang Tang has now thrown Wendigo over the top and is trying to go after him. Tsuji missing with a kick on Dervish. And Wendigo has been eliminated by Wang Tang. Thunder throwing Toril over the top rope, trying to get an elimination here. Wang Tang kind of biding his time, watching, kind of seeing what's going on between Tsuji and Dervish. And working with Tsuji here, maybe not, to try to go with the elimination. And now stopping the elimination at this point with a punch against Tsuji. Tsuji standing tall, maybe taking a breather before taking a kick at Dervish. Toril taking Toril on the ground after a hit from Thunder here. Wang Tang crawling back to his feet. And now back up. Tsuji perhaps looking to eliminate a corner elimination here against Dervish. That did not work. Dervish throwing him over the top now, trying to hope for an elimination. Toril has Thunder under the ropes, trying to push him off and get him eliminated here. Buzzer has gone off. We now have our next entry into the Rumble. Would be another member of the corporation, Chainsaw. Thunder immediately picking Chainsaw up and slamming him down. We saw Tsuji go for a move on Toril there. Toril push off. Tsuji did counter with a flip. Looks like we have Dervish and Wang Tang going at it here. Wang Tang knee her looking to be hurting. Dervish with a suplex on Tsuji. Chainsaw now throwing Thunder to the outside, hoping maybe for elimination. Wang Tang now trying to eliminate, Dervish now trying to eliminate Wang Tang, pushing him over the top rope. And a drop kick. Wang Tang has been eliminated. Wang Tang not agreeing with the call there, but unfortunately it does stand. Looks like Toril is trying to eliminate Tsuji at this point in time. Tsuji has rolled back into the ring, is safe for the moment. Chainsaw wastes no time going after him, though. Toril, of course, throwing Dervish over the top rope. Thunder crawling for the ropes, perhaps trying to stand up. Did stand up on his own without the ropes. Of course, timer is counting down. We will have our next competitor entering the ring now that we're back down to five. Tsuji thrown over, but is safe again now. Tsuji going after Chainsaw, walking him over to the ropes. And trying to push him out. Slam by Toril. A vicious slam on Dervish. Thunder proceeding to throw Toril over the top. Trying to eliminate him. Drop kick by Tsuji. And Chainsaw is still in. Timer has gone off. We have our next entry into the Royal Rumble match here. Is Boppo the Clown. Tsuji with a springboard moonsault on Chainsaw. And there were some vicious right hooks in the corner against Toril. And looking to just maybe try to lift Toril up over the turnbuckle now. Now a Irish whip by Thunder. Got Toril on the outside. See if we can push him over. And Boppo trying to eliminate Tsuji. Tsuji with a counter there. Ooh, but Boppo with another vicious punch. And another throw against the ropes. Not a place any of these competitors want to be is anywhere near the ropes in this match. Boppo trying to eliminate Tsuji. Tsuji rolls back in. Chainsaw has eliminated Whirling Dervish, ladies and gentlemen. We have another elimination here. Chainsaw now working on eliminating Boppo, but Boppo with a shoulder block and is back in. Toril throwing Thunder over the top rope. He's laying on the ground, trying to finish pushing him out to get the elimination. And we have another elimination. Toril has eliminated Thunder. Is now going after the champion, Tsuji. Perhaps feeling maybe he can soften him up a bit to try to get the win here. And maybe perhaps inflict some damage for the Elimination Chamber main event that we have here. Boppo trying to eliminate Chainsaw here. And we have another elimination. Chainsaw's been eliminated. Oh, I just saw the Stealth Bomber by Tsuji. Ladies and gentlemen, we have our final three men in the ring. Tsuji with a kick on Boppo. So we can tell you this at least now, ladies and gentlemen. Your tag team champion will be one of these three men. I guess it could be two of these three men if the winner chooses one of the other two as his partner. Fortunately, that we'll probably have to wait until Thursday Night Brawl to find out exactly who is going to be the winner. Looks like Toril and Tsuji teaming up on Boppo here. Toril letting Tsuji do the work, maybe trying to catch his breath a little bit here. Let Tsuji wear himself down so that Toril can take advantage of whatever happens here. Toril not going to work. Tsuji kind of standing back and watching. And Tsuji now trying to push Toril out of the ring. Boppo standing and watching, catching his breath, waiting to see what happens. Tsuji has eliminated Toril. Ladies and gentlemen, we have our final two competitors. It is Tsuji Sato and Boppo the Clown. Area 51 versus the Corporation. Tsuji throwing Boppo over the top. And not for sure. Looked like he was trying to grab him there. Maybe missed. Let's see what happens here, ladies and gentlemen. Tsuji. Oh, counter by Boppo. Looked like maybe Tsuji was going for an underhook DDT. Boppo stomping on the elbow there. Boppo picking Tsuji up. Tsuji counters with a belly-to-back suplex. Tsuji with a shot to the back on Boppo. Boppo with an Irish whip throwing Tsuji over the top. And Tsuji rolls back in. Tsuji returning the favor with an Irish whip of his own here. Looks like Suji's now going to try to push Boppo out of the ring. And Boppo fighting for dear life, trying to hang on here. And looks like we are good. Boppo is back in. This match continues. Tsuji staying on the offensive here, trying to get this elimination. Again, Tsuji gets him over the top rope, but he is laying there. He's pushing. He almost has him. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a winner. Now, with assumption will be, you know, your winner and one half of your new VWF Tag Team Champions, Tsuji Sato. You would think Tsuji is going to choose Doc as his tag team partner, but you never know. You never know what may happen with this here. We could see a new team being formed. We will anxiously await to see who Tsuji chooses as his new partner to be the Tag Team Champions. I got to give credit to Tsuji. He said in his interview before, this is what he was here for, and he came and got the job done. Now, we will see if Tsuji Sato can enter the Elimination Chamber and walk out as still the VWF Heavyweight Champion. Ladies and gentlemen, that is your main event, and it is next. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we have our main event for the evening. It is Elimination Chamber match. It is for the VWF World Heavyweight Championship. As you can see, we have four of the entrants locked inside of the pods. The way this match works, two men start off at intervals. One of the pods will randomly open. Another entrant will come out. You have to, of course, pinfall or submission, eliminate your opponent. The last man standing, of course, is your VWF Heavyweight Champion. Of course, going into this match, Tsuji Sato is your champion. Looks like he lucked out as not being the first entry in the ring. As we can tell, it looks like a new outfit there for Tsuji, maybe to commemorate our partnership tonight with the X1 Bros. Old Drifter and Toro battling it out here. Hoping maybe get an early elimination before more men are thrown into the mix. Vicious chop by Helldrifter on Toro there. And Tsuji is our next competitor into the ring here. Tsuji standing and waiting. Maybe to see what happened. Yeah, let the pinfall go. Why not? Tsuji now taking a drop kick after Helldrifter. Helldrifter moving out of the way and slamming Tsuji down at this point. Looks like over in the other corner, it looks like maybe DB Black is actually sporting some new trunks. Also maybe looks to be in recognition of our partnership with the X1 Bros this evening. Of course, the X1 Bros are your positive gaming experience. Make sure to check them out at x1bros.com. They have their own forums there. You can also find them in Google Play, on podcasts, or on iTunes. Helldrifter going after Tsuji here. Toro standing back up. Our next pot is open. Kid Nikki is our next entrant into the match here. Of course, Kid Nikki is our new VWF Television Champion after the triple threat match, Hell in a Cell, earlier this evening. Kid Nikki throwing Toril out on the outside, going for a pinfall. Only getting a two count. Of course, this outside the ring is not your standard padded. Of course, it is a steel mesh or for support. Tsuji up on the top rope with a 450 splash. Looks like Tsuji's now going after Kid Nikki. Toril going for the pinfall on Helldrifter. Only getting a two count. Kid Nikki up with the Hurricane Rana on Tsuji there. The DB Black is our next competitor entering the ring. Got to assume he's probably going to be going after Kid Nikki in retaliation for losing his television title. Or no, he is going to go after the champion. Obviously, figure eliminate the champion, make a name for himself. Tsuji countering that move, though. Toril going for another pinfall on Helldrifter. The Helldrifter with a kick out at 2.5. All five men still alive in this match. Craig Casey looking to have the advantage here this evening, being the last man to be in the pods. Of course, got to have a little bit of an advantage there, having time for the other men to kind of wear each other down, wear themselves out, come in fresh towards later. Kid Nikki going for a pin on Toril. Only getting two count. Close there, but Toril did get his shoulders up. DB Black with a club to the back on Helldrifter. Now that final pot is open, and Angel has entered the ring. Going for a Luthez press on Toril there. All six men going at it in the ring. DB Black with a pinfall attempt on Helldrifter. Helldrifter with a kick out. Tsuji and Kid Nikki going at it here. Oh, Kid Nikki with a counter and a punch on Tsuji. Tsuji with the standing neck breaker there on Kid Nikki. DB Black going up to the top rope. See more eliminations. Kid Nikki with a counter on Tsuji. Helldrifter pushing DB Black back. Looks like we may have a head wrench by Toril on Angel outside the ring. DB Black putting Helldrifter against the middle rope. And now what is he going for? Oh, a knee press on the rope, trying to choke him out there. Now going for the pin. One, two, three. Ladies and gentlemen, we have our first elimination. Helldrifter has been eliminated from this match. Or maybe not. Nope, Helldrifter is climbing out. He has been eliminated. A little bit of magic there as Helldrifter just kind of disappeared off into nowhere there. Of course, it looks, unfortunately, you know, Angel had Toril pinned around the same time, but it looked like the ref was busy counting. Oh, a pop-up powerbomb by DB Black on Tsuji, going for the pin. One, two, no, not getting the three count there. As I was stating, Angel had the pin going on Toril, but I believe the ref did not see it as he was in the process of counting Helldrifter out. So Toril perhaps saved there, not for sure the exact timing if Toril got the shoulder up before three or if that three count would have hit first. Either way, he is still in the match. And Tsuji and DB Black going at it in the ring. And Toril back in the ring now. Everyone else climbing back in. Tsuji with a DDT on DB Black. Craig Casey going after the angel, or going after the elbow of Toril there. Kid Nikki with an Irish whip. Tsuji looks like working on the knee of DB Black there. And DB Black with a counter. Now Toril picking Tsuji up. And power slam. DB Black whipping Toril into the corner. Toril reversing it, throwing him in the corner. Angel grabbing Toril. Now Angel going after DB Black, perhaps setting up for the I'm sorry, the fall from grace, the top rope superplex. I had forgotten the name there for a minute. Had to look at my cheat sheet. I apologize about that. Toral going for the pin on Kid Nikki. One, two, a kick out, and DB Black getting the kick out on Angel's pin attempt. Toral now proceeding to beat down on Kid Nikki. Angel with the pride lock on DB Black. Looks like there was no submission there, but you can tell Black's back is killing him. Angel now going for the pinfall. Looks like Tsuji did bust open Toral. Looks like we maybe have a little bit of bleeding out there. Kid Nikki now going with a leg drop on the knee of DB Black. Angel, what is Angel going for here? All right, suplex here on Kid Nikki. Tsuji throwing Toral back into the ring. Looks like now DB Black going after Craig Casey or Angel, however you want to refer to him. Toral with a pickup. Oh, and a vicious gut buster there on Tsuji. That may have been the leg splitter. Ladies and gentlemen, we will have a new VWF Heavyweight Champion as Tsuji has been eliminated by Toral. DB Black now going for the pin on Angel. Not successful. We have four men left. It looks like Toral is waiting here. Clothesline from hell onto Kid Nikki. That is what he calls the decapitator. One, two, and a kick out. Kid Nikki is still in the match. Toral with an Irish whip outside the ring. Ooh, Angel with a sidestep there. DB Black hitting nothing but turnbuckle. DB Black said he would walk out of tonight with at least one championship. Unfortunately, he did lose the television title. Oh, Kid Nikki with the crawl on Toral. DB Black going up to the top rope. Oh! Vicious there. Did not get a submission, but DB Black going for pinfall. Did not get it. Kid Nikki did not get the submission on the crawl from Toral. So all four men still going at it. Two in the ring, two outside of the ring. Turning him around, lifting him up. Are we perhaps going to see the fall from grace again here? Toral throwing Kid Nikki back into the ring. Angel hits the fall from grace. Is he going to go for the pin? One, two, and no. DB Black kicks out. His dream of walking out champion is still alive. Toral throwing Kid Nikki. I can't even say throwing. He gently lifted Kid Nikki the little bit up to the top rope there. Ooh, a suplex from the top rope there. Looks like Angel is working on the legs and back of DB Black there. Toral squeezing the head of Kid Nikki there. Trying to inflict as much damage as he can. Pop-up powerbomb by DB Black. I'm not sure the ref saw it. Now he did. One, two, and a kick out at two and a half. Angel is still alive. Uppercut by Kid Nikki. A overhand chop and a boot by Toral. Looks like we have a counter by Kid Nikki. Oh, the reverse Death Valley driver on the outside by DB Black. Catching his breath, going for a pinfall, it looks here. No, he is going for a choke on Angel. Not wanting to eliminate him yet. And I believe we're getting the leg splitter, the backbreaker gut buster there on Kid Nikki by Toral. And DB Black is now in the ring. Looks like Toral's going for the pinfall. One, two, and a kick out by Kid Nikki. Match still continues with all four competitors. DB Black going back in the ring, going after Angel again. DB Black moving a little slow. You got to figure tonight's matches have probably wore three of these four competitors down. Almost makes you think it's Toril at an advantage here with the triple threat match that the other three went through earlier. Toril waiting. Toril hitting Kid Nikki with the Gravedigger and going for the pin. One, two, and a kick out. Kid Nikki is still in the match, ladies and gentlemen. And a nice drop kick by Kid Nikki to counter. DB Black with a club in the corner. And now, looks like he's setting Angel up on the top row. Kid Nikki still going after Toril. Craig Casey countering there. Did not go for a top rope move, just decided to go. Oh, and I missed it. We have the Craw by Kid Nikki onto Toril. Angel now going after Kid Nikki while Toril and DB Black lay motionless in the ring. Craig Casey going for a pinfall. One. Kid Nikki kicks out again. You cannot keep the little man in yellow down, it seems like. Vicious kick and club to the back by DB Black. Looks like he's now going after Angel for another pinfall. And a kick out there. Toril is still down on the ground after all this. Kid Nikki looks like he's waiting for Toril to get up. Are we going to see the Shanghai Surprise? Shanghai Surprise by Kid Nikki going for the pin. And we have another elimination. Toril has been eliminated by Kid Nikki. Ladies and gentlemen, we now have our triple threat match back in action with Angel and Kid Nikki and DB Black. The bad blood between these men continues, and one of these three men will walk out champion. Of course, Kid Nikki already your television champion. Will he walk out with two titles? Or will DB Black exchange the TV title in exchange for being your heavyweight champion? Or will Angel walk out your heavyweight champion? DB Black throwing Angel back into the ring, climbing in. Kid Nikki going for a punch there, but looks like he missed. Oh, but he did not miss with that. I thought he was going to get picked up in a slam by DB Black, but he countered that there. Angel lifting Black to his feet. And Irish whip into the corner. And are we looking for perhaps another fall from grace by Angel? No, Kid Nikki is not allowing it. Kid Nikki jumping up and going for the Hurricane Rana. And a pinfall attempt. One, two. No, it was only two. I thought we had a three count there. The ref raised his hands, though, and said only two count there. Angel is still alive. He has got the Irish whip now on Kid Nikki. It looks like perhaps he is setting up to go for the fall from grace on Kid Nikki now. Looks to be a little wobbly, though. Maybe the effects of tonight wearing on all three men. DB Black watching, waiting. Angel with the fall from grace, but he's not going for the pinfall, picking Nikki up right away. Pop-up powerbomb by DB Black out of nowhere, going for the pin. And we have a three count, ladies and gentlemen. We now know your champion will be Kid Nikki or DB Black. We will either have a man with two titles or a man walking out of here with the title, like he said. Kid Nikki going for the pinfall. DB Black getting that kick out there. Kid Nikki with a kick to the back there on DB Black, standing him back up. And we have a Craw by Kid Nikki on DB Black. DB Black fighting it off, trying not to go for the submission here. He did not submit. He is still going. Kid Nikki, looks like he's got plenty of energy dancing here in the ring, waiting for it. Maybe a little bit of showboating before he goes for that pinfall attempt. DB Black kicking out before the three count. slowly getting to his feet, but Kid Nicky with a punch and a chop to the head to do what he can. And ladies and gentlemen, it is the Shanghai Surprise. And a kick out by DB Black. This match continues again. Kid Nicky obviously wore out, barely getting going to his knees after that. DB Black fighting to get to his feet. These two men have given it their all night. Whether you talk the triple threat match, the Royal Rumble, or this match in general, and a sidestep by Kid Nicky. Oh, but a counter by DB Black. Going for a headbutt, but another counter drop down by Kid Nicky. Looks like Kid Nicky is now going to work on the legs of DB Black some more. Nope, flipping him back over. And just an elbow to the midsection. Kid Nicky may be catching his breath here, kind of waiting here, going for a kick to the back of the leg there. Doing what he can to wear DB Black down. DB Black not showing much offense here, maybe trying to catch his breath. Running knee into a bulldog by Kid Nicky. Kid Nicky on the offensive here, trying to drag Black into the middle of the ring. And a chop to the back of the head. Maybe not even so much chop, that sounded more like a slap. Can we get a woo? Oh, but DB Black with a counter. DB Black now with a kick to the back of the knee on Kid Nicky. Standing him up here. Kid Nicky with a counter and a push off here. Kid Nicky going for the pin. No, DB Black kicked out. This match is still going on, ladies and gentlemen. Black with a counter. DB Black, or Kid Nicky, going for another move here. And a drop kick off the ropes. But Kid Nicky down to his knees. He is wore out. Of course, DB Black still on the ground. You got to feel he is wore out too. Not even getting up as quick as he used to. Kid Nicky slowly going over to the corner, but a boot reversal by DB Black. Suplex onto Kid Nicky. You've got to think maybe the next Shanghai Surprise or reverse Death Valley Driver is going to be the end of this match. And speaking of reverse Death Valley Driver, ladies and gentlemen, here goes DB Black, and he hits the reverse Death Valley Driver on Kid Nicky and is now going for the pin. There is your three count, ladies and gentlemen. The match has been won. Your winner and new VWF World Heavyweight Champion, DB Black. The man kept his word. He said he would walk out tonight with at least one championship. And he is now your World Heavyweight Champion, ladies and gentlemen. He has survived brutality tonight, lost his TV title to Kid Nicky in the triple threat match, in the Royal Rumble, and then wins the Elimination Chamber match to become your heavyweight champion. It'll be interesting to see what DB Black has to say. I'm sure he will let us know that he is a man of his word and lived up to the claim that he made. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us tonight. Please check out VWFgroup.com, your homepage for the VWF. And don't forget to go check out our sponsor and partner for tonight, X1 Bros. You can find their podcast on iTunes. You can find it on Google. Or you can go to X1Bros.com and join the forums. Thank you for joining us, ladies and gentlemen. It has been an amazing evening. Thank you for watching. Please like the video. Please subscribe to the channel. Please come to VWFgroup.com and join us for our next wonderful event, our next Thursday Night Brawl leading up to our next pay-per-view being announced right here, Breaking Point, in a month. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and good night.